Welcome to everyone. In this class, we are going to discuss about economics third lesson, food security and nutrition. So in this lesson, we are going to discuss about what is food and what is importance of nutrition. Food is defined as any substance because we are taking many kind of food. So it is defined as any substance that people eat and drink to maintain the life and growth is called as food. And food security, it does denote the person's ability to eat enough because we cannot take more food. So ability to eat enough, stay active and lead the healthy life, it is called as food security. So if you are taking enough of food, it is called as food security. So this food security, the United Nations Food and Agricultural Organization, they define as food security is when all people, all time have physical, social and economic access to sufficient, safe and nutritious food, which meet their preferences to active the healthy life. So people they are taking all the time, all the people, physical, social and economics to live the healthy life is called as food security. It is set by Food and Agricultural Organization 2009. And Dr. M.S. Swaminathan, he is the father of Green Revolution. He is the father of Green Revolution. So Dr. M.S. Swaminathan, he said physical, economic and social access to the balanced diet. Okay, if you are using economic, social access to the balanced diet, so safe drinking water, environmental hygiene, primary health care and primary education. So it is the importance of food security. Next one, basic components of food and nutrition security. So there are three basic components of food and nutrition security. First one is availability of food. Second one, access to food. Next one is absorption. So the availability of food. So this food stock, we are keeping the desired quantity. How much we are keeping the quantity for our domestic production as well import. The stock and import is called as availability of food. Because all the time we need the food. Okay. So that we are keeping quantity. Okay. So availability of quantity is called as availability of food. Next one is access to food. So this matter purchasing power. So if you want to purchase the food means we need employment opportunities and education and asset. Then only we can purchase all kind of food. Or else we cannot purchase all kind of food. So we need employment opportunities, asset and education is called as access to food. Next one is absorption. So this is ability to biological utilize the food consumed. So it is biological utilize to food consumed is called as absorption. So this is the basic components of food and nutrition security. Next one is availability and access to food grains. So which is called food grains, pulses, meat. So this all example for the food grains. So this food security for people in a country is not only depend on quantum of food available. It also is depend on purchase food and stay in the appropriate healthy environment. Okay. So this food security is not only depend on quantity, it is depend on environment. Okay, healthy environment. So this developmental issues, food security of people is also related to country overall development process. So this food security is overall development process. It is depend on overall development process. So after the independence, India chose to adopt the developmental model. They plan to develop the industrial. Okay. So before independence, India is depend on agricultural country. After independence, India given the importance of industrial. So that they given the priority. So importance of industrialization. So United States of America, they extended the given help to India, Public Law 480. Okay, the law, Public Law 480, PL 480 scheme to India during the 1960s. Because we got freedom in 1947. In that time, we are economically poor. Okay, so that America, United States of America helped to India, Public Law 480 to develop the food grains in India. So the American administration and philanthropic organization, so both also joined together and they helped to India started the food production in country by introducing high yielding varieties, wheat and rice. Okay, so this United States of America, they given the importance of India, they introduced high yielding varieties, HYV, the short form of HYV. So this program was implemented the selected district. Okay, so this is implemented only the selected district where it is available of irrigation. So what is irrigation? All the time we are not getting the water, the storing of water is called as irrigation. So with the help of irrigation, they started the high yielding varieties. So this program covered many number of district. This program is covered many number of district. So with the help of green revolution was born in self-sufficiency in food grain production. They started the green revolution. The father of green revolution is Dr. M.S. Swaminathan. So they increased food grain after introducing this high yielding varieties. The increased food grain production was made possible by an increased area cultivated with HYV. Okay, so what is HYV? High yielding varieties, rice and wheat. So which area is possible? In that area, they cultivated more rice and wheat with help of this high yield varieties. So area under food grains was little more 98 million hectares. Okay, they started the cultivate 98 million hectares during the 1950. During 1950, they cultivated 98 million hectares. After this, implement of growth in food grain production was made possible by the HYV program. So with help of this HYV program, they cultivated rice and wheat, high yielding varieties. They cultivated more rice and wheat. Okay, so that they started the minimum support price, MSP. They started introduced minimum support price for the crops were announced by the beginning of the season. So beginning of the season, they introduced minimum support price. The state procured the harvested grain through the Food Corporation of India. So they given the amount. So with help of this MSP, they given the amount to cultivators. Okay, MSP means minimum support price. For example, if they cultivate any crops, the government fix on net. Okay, so the minimum, they fix on rate. If they get more than rate, they can go to the open market or else they can come to the government. So it is called as minimum support price. And introducing fertilizer to cultivate more crops, introduced fertilizer and they cultivate more wheat and paddy. So during the time, so India depend on import. So during the time, India is depend on import to meet the requirement of people, because all the crops we cannot cultivate in our country, so that they depend on import. The rapid increase in food grain production was accompanied by appropriate technological intervention. So they developed with the help of technological intervention dairy, poultry and fisheries sector. As the result, they introduced more 8 increase. Okay, 8% of increased egg production and 40% of egg and 30% of fish. Increased many dairy product. Okay. And the time of independence and the mid 2000 in this period, they developed many dairy product, but pulses and oil seeds are not developed in our country. So in this we depend on import to the other country, exported import to the other country. So pulses and oil seeds are not developed during the 2000 period. Okay. Next one is public distribution system. So which means ration shop. The simple form, if you want to say, means ration shop is called as public distribution system. So Tamil Nadu has adopted the universal PDS. So what is PDS? Public distribution system. So our Tamil Nadu has adopted universal PDS. But other state in India, they adopted targeted PDS. Okay. So in our Tamil Nadu has adopted universal PDS. And other state in India, they adopted only targeted PDS. So what is different between both this universal PDS and targeted PDS? So universal PDS, in our Tamil Nadu, they given the ration card most of the people. Okay, so more than people, they distributed the ration card. So in that ration card, any people can get the ration shop from ration. Okay. So they can get the ration shop. But this targeted PDS, only less people, only selective people alone, they're giving the ration product. Okay. So this universal PDS, they're giving the more person, they're giving more person in Tamil Nadu. But targeted PDS, they're giving only very less person in Tamil Nadu. Next one is National Food Security Act. It was passed in our Indian Parliament 2013. It was passed in 2013. So this National Food Security Act, so the help of it is covering 50% of the urban household and 75% of the rural household. Okay, this National Food Security Act, NFSA. So it is covering 50% of urban household and 75% of rural household. So with the help of this, they are giving many product to the people. Next one, role of consumer cooperatives in food security. So consumer cooperative play an important role of the supply of quality goods. So the consumer cooperative is the responsible to supply the quality goods at a responsible rate to common people. Okay, they're supplying the quality goods to the common people. So the structure of consumer cooperative society in India, there are three tier structure. We are divided into three tier structure of our consumer cooperative society in India. So they are primary consumer cooperative society, next is central consumer cooperative, and next one is village level. Okay, so village level cooperative. So this giving 50,000 village level society or engaged the distribution of consumer goods. So they're giving the 50,000 village level and rural area. So this scheme is giving the importance of food security in India. Food security. So giving the food security in India, this cooperative scheme. For example, all fair price shops running in Tamil Nadu, 94% be run by the cooperative. Okay, 94% it is run by cooperatives. Next one is buffer stock. So buffer stock means all the product we are not getting all the time. So just a stock, maintaining the stock is called as buffer stock. With help of this stock, you are taking whole year. Okay, this goods you are taking whole year is called as buffer stock. So this buffer stock is the stock of food grains, namely wheat and rice. Because the south side we are expecting the rice and north side we are expecting the wheat. Okay. So with help of this Food Corporation of India, they are maintaining the stock. And the FCI purchase wheat and rice from the farmer in state there is surplus production. So how they are maintaining the stock means surplus, extra product they are purchasing by Food Corporation of India. Okay, purchasing by Food Corporation of India and maintaining the stock. The farmer are paid the pre-announced price for their crop, that is called as minimum support price. We discussed about minimum support price. So what is minimum support price? One product, the government fixing the rate. If they want to go to the open market, they can go to the open market, or else they can come to the government sector. It is called as minimum support price. So government fixing the rate, minimum rate. So this minimum support price is declared by government every year. It is declared by government every year before the sowing season to provide the incentives to farmer for raising the production of this crops. Okay, so before sowing, giving some amount to the farmer. So the purchased food grains are stored in granaries. So this extra, the surplus purchased food grains are stored in granaries. This also help resolve the problem of shortage of food during the adverse weather condition or during the period of calamity. Okay, because the surplus product while they are purchasing, it does help us to weather condition, bad weather condition, in that time we cannot cultivate the crops. For example, if you see this time onion rate 1 kg is more than 100 or 200 rupees, but remaining time it is 1 kg is rupees 10, 20 or 50. So this surplus getting the product and the storing in the stock. Okay, they are just maintaining the stock. So it is called as buffer stock. Next one is recap. So what we discuss in this lesson. So food is defined as any substance. Okay, it is defined as any substance that people can eat, drink to maintain life and growth. Okay. So, people eat and drink to maintain the life and growth, we are taking the food. And food security is when all the people, all the time, have physical, society and economic access to sufficient for an active and healthy life. So, people living an active and healthy life with the help of food security. And next one, National Food Security Act was passed by the Indian Parliament 2013. So what is the National Food Security Act? They maintaining their stock. Okay, with the help of this National Food Security Act. It was passed in 2013. So Parliament means central government. It was passed in central government in 2013. Next one, learn the following. Your question is define food security according to FAO. Okay. So, define food security according to FAO. Next one is elaborate the public distribution system. Elaborate the public distribution system. Next one, explain availability and access to food grains. Explain availability and access to food grains. Okay. So, read well. Thank you. Have a nice day.